is your First Alert 5 weather with Mike Daniels.
Great to have you with us here on News 5 at 5. It's cold out there. We've got cloudy skies, but flake-free for the time being across Colorado Springs. Pueblo, a lot of clouds, quite a bit warmer. Still 40 in Pueblo. There's a cold front hanging up right between Colorado Springs and Pueblo right now. There is snow on the way, but for now, we're really quiet across El Paso County. You've got to look really hard to find any flurries. Way out 24 around the Simla area, all the way back to portions of Rame. A couple of snowflakes. That is pretty much it. In Pueblo, you're flake-free as well. Actually had a couple of rain sprinkles across parts of Pueblo earlier this afternoon. Pretty well-organized pocket of rain, mainly just light showers right now, stretching along Highway 50 and Point South, and still cold enough for some snow west of I-25, just to the south of La Vida Pass right now. Here's how this whole thing is going to evolve. This is 8 o'clock tonight. I think we'll see mainly light snow across Colorado Springs and Pueblo, where you see those darker blues. That's where the heavier band of snow is going to set up. And again, that'll be along and south of Highway 50. We'll see little pockets of energy create some snow across our area. A lot of that snow is going to wrap up by about mid to late morning tomorrow morning. Yes, you could see stray leftover flurries at times tomorrow afternoon across parts of El Paso County, but the worst will be over by mid to late tomorrow morning. Not the biggest fall of snow we've ever had across our area. Anywhere from 2 inches of snow across Colorado Springs and Pueblo up to 3, maybe 4 across the Monument area. Then storm number 2 comes in late on Wednesday. I think we'll be dry through at least mid-afternoon on Wednesday. Then as that next pocket of energy gets closer, here we go again. By Wednesday evening, flurries flying up and down I-25. Going to see that snow continue through at least early Thursday morning. Then actually seeing some pockets of sunshine by Thursday afternoon. Again, these are our snow totals from tonight through midday tomorrow. Not the biggest fall of snow we've ever had around here, but those roads will be slick and icy across parts of the viewing area tomorrow morning. So extra time, extra room, and extra patience once again. Current temperatures much colder across the Pikes Peak region into the 20s. We're still into the 40s along the Arkansas River. In fact, Lamar currently at 47 degrees. Here's how cold we get tonight, dropping back into the teens and 20s with cloudy skies and occasional pockets of snow around here. Afternoon highs tomorrow much colder than what we had the past couple of days. 30 in the Springs. Pueblo tomorrow, an afternoon high temperature of 33 degrees. Big takeaway from this forecast for the next 24 hours. Look out for slick, icy conditions later tonight through the commute tomorrow morning. Here comes storm number 2 late on Wednesday into Thursday morning. So we'll be on weather alert for at least the next 3 days. Really cold for this time of the year. We warm up as we head into the weekend. Really not bad on Saturday. We'll hit 47. Then that next storm system comes in Saturday night. I think it'll exit by Sunday morning, so still not a bad day on Sunday, and then possibility of still a new storm coming in by next Monday. In Pueblo, unsettled is the big weather word for at least the next 7 days. You can see snow tomorrow into Wednesday. That storm Wednesday is late Wednesday into early Thursday morning, so even though I don't think we'll see a whole lot of snow flying on Thursday, we're still going to go weather alert for Thursday for the possibility of those slick roads during that Thursday morning commute. Not a bad day Saturday. 50 before that storm rolls in late Saturday night into early Sunday morning. Canyon City, a very similar pattern. Cold and unsettled is the main message here over the next 3 days at least. Afternoon high on Thursday, only 29 degrees, and then more snow possible by late Saturday night. And in Woodland Park, you're going to be awfully cold. Highs of 26 the next couple of days with snow up there. Not your biggest fall of snow either, but again, we know it doesn't take a whole lot of snow to create slick and icy conditions. So stay tuned. We'll be on weather alert tomorrow. Sam will be in early with an update on that forecast.